Take one part thrills, one part laughter, one part spectacle, stir with plenty of band music, and you have the circus, the same world of joy and magic that thrilled audiences in ancient Rome and the Circus Maximus. Now the circus has returned to the arena bigger and better than ever. The American circus has always been a traveling affair, but now the performers travel on superhighways between cities in modern, comfortable trailers. The costumes, floats, and all the fantastic paraphernalia that spells circus, from clown's wigs to elephant ballet skirts, are loaded into giant trailer trucks, up-to-date versions of the horse-drawn circus wagons of yesteryear. Elephants and circuses have always gone together. Circus elephants are usually Asian females, since males are considered too hard to train. Here, however, is an African pygmy male, the first to travel with a big show. Circus horses, considered among the finest in the world, get constant attention from the circus veterinarian. Another circus tradition that has continued through the years is the parade, in which all the performers participate. It's called a spectacle now, and is bigger in scope and more beautiful than ever. Watching it, it's easy to imagine that you're indeed in the world of the Arabian Nights. The piercing whistle of the ringmaster has long been the signal for a new act to begin. In a second, you're soaring through space on a flying trapeze. The whistle sounds, and you gasp while a man juggles flaming torches while hanging by his hair. A covered wagon races past, heralding a rousing Wild West pageant of colors and excitement. A juggler does the impossible, suspended by his teeth. A red-nosed clown with baggy trousers performs in comic pantomime. It is, as always, a place where anything can happen, even dancing dogs. A modern note is injected when a spaceship lands from out of nowhere and releases its tiny passenger, the smallest man since Tom Thumb. People say that clowns are as old as the circus. Strictly speaking, they're much older, for the main traditions of clown costuming and clown business reach back to the theater of ancient Greece and follow a continuous line to the present day. From the small traveling theater troupes of Renaissance France and Italy comes the tradition of Pagliacci, the clown who hides his broken heart behind a ludicrously painted red rim. It was Joseph Grimaldi, the great Italian comic, who evolved the traditional clown face makeup. And since his day, clowns have held each face sacred to its owner. No one may copy it until that clown retires, at which time he will choose a younger clown as his successor. With a history that's nearly as old as civilization itself, the circus still retains its indefinable appeal that starts with the first note of the circus band and continues through 2 hours of the spectacular, the impossible, and the forever incredible. The circus will be with us forever. Thank you.